Hi, and welcome to Channel 4 News. We are here in Studio Y. I am Barbara Peterson.
And my name is Kurt Buster. We are very excited to get to the news and notes of the day, and we want to start out by talking about sports. Michigan football had another game last night against South Dakota State Technical College. They ended up losing again by another 40 points, but you know what? That's better than last week.
Yeah, Kurt, I mean, Coach Harbaugh just has not been able to pull it together.
Wait a second here. We got breaking news coming in. We have an incident that has occurred in Spanish Fork, Utah. There seems to be an escape.
An escape? What's escape?
You see, this is the thing, Barb. This escape is with llamas.
Llamas. Oh no. Yeah, it looks like they have found llamas. They have live video footage of llamas escaping their habitation and running along the road in Spanish Fork, Utah. Let's cut to that footage. I cannot believe that footage. Did you see those llamas running and going? I think they're more athletic than Michigan's football team, if I'm being quite honest.
You know, Barb, they are certainly going somewhere fast. Let's cut to Dean, who's live on the scene, for more info.
Yeah, thanks, Barb. We're here at the site of the Hare Krishna Temple here in Spanish Fork, where two llamas have recently gone missing. And we're gonna go talk to the owner to find out what's going on.
I'm here with Raj.
Raj Wagner,
who is the owner of Utah Valley Llamas here in Spanish Fork. Now, Raj, when exactly did these llamas go missing?
About 2 days ago, they disappeared. And I milked the cow and I look and they're not dead.
Fascinating, folks.
So I got one, two.
You said you bought these llamas in Kazakhstan, but
yes.
Rumors have been circulating that they're actually from Ohio. So I don't know if you'd like to make any comments on that.
Okay.
Anything to say?
No more camera.
Okay, come on, we gotta get out of here. Let's go. Oh gosh, we gotta go.
A morning in Spanish Fork that ended quite differently than expected. This is Dean Williams signing off. Back to you, Barb and Kurt.
Thanks, Dean. Wow, what an amazing, interesting story. I really wasn't expecting to get this in today.
Yeah, well, developing, we have another sighting of the llamas, and we will go to Cheryl with more information there.
Hi, it's me, Cheryl. We're here at the scene of Red Fuego, the reported site where the llamas have disappeared to. So far, we have not seen the llamas, but we are gonna ask around and see if we can locate them. Oh, sir.
Hey!
Hello, have you seen llamas?
Yeah, I've seen the llamas.
Really? Yes.
Yeah.
What is your name?
I am the Jeremy Moore, owner of Red Fuego.
Oh, wow. That's kind of a big deal. So you notice llamas around this area. Tell me about that.
Yeah. So they're big, they're hairy, they're very llama-y. They don't have the humps like the camels, though.
Wow, that's so interesting that they came here. Do you have a theory why?
Yeah, it's because my chicken, my Peruvian chicken. It's so authentic, they flock.
Wow, you heard it here, folks.
That was footage just in from reporter Cheryl. She's out in the field at Red Fuego, a Peruvian restaurant, and she just spoke with the owner, Jeremy Moore, and it appears that the llamas have ended up there. That's a long ways from Spanish Fork.
Sure is. Do you think they're eating the chicken at the restaurant?
Good one, Kurt. Well, let's go back to Cheryl in the field to see what else she's been able to uncover.
Yes, thank you, Kurt. We're back here at Red Fuego, where we're with local llama expert Dr. Doolittle, here to answer some questions about why this strange occurrence might have happened. Although, Dr. Doolittle, you just told me that this is actually the fourth time this year that llamas have come to Red Fuego. Why is that?
So this is actually something I've been looking into for a long time. Of course, course, we have to remember what llamas really are, that their natural habitat is Peru and in the Andes mountain range. And that's not Spanish Fork, Utah.
Yeah, yeah.
So these llamas have a natural instinct to be in their natural habitat. And so they keep coming to the most authentically Peruvian place that they know, and that's Red Fuego. It's got the most authentic, it's the closest to Peru that they can find.
Oh,
and so
very
they're naturally drawn to this location.
Wow, that's so interesting. We heard it from Dr. Doolittle. This is a natural instinct of llamas to come to find the most authentic Peruvian food, and that is Red Fuego. Thank you. Back to you, Kurt.
Thank you, Cheryl. Wow, what a treat to hear from such an expert on llamas.
It's true. I mean, Dr. Doolittle, you can tell that he just has studied this for years and really understands the llama's migration patterns.
Yeah, and now it's time for our commercial break.
To Studio Y. We'll continue to give you live updates on the llama escape as they come in, but for now we're going to pivot and talk about an upcoming and successful restaurant right here in Orem, Utah.
That's right, Barb. Red Fuego had their grand reopening of their Orem location, and a group of marketing students from Brigham Young University led the campaign, and it looked to be very successful.
Wow, Kurt, those marketing students are sharp and their professors are amazing. Let's take a look at the footage we have of the event. Hey DJ, póngale la música que le gusta. Una para que se mueva y se luzca. Baile conmigo, solo conmigo. Hey DJ, póngale la música que le gusta. Una para que se mueva y se luzca. Baile conmigo, solo conmigo. Hey. Y así nos vamos enamorando. Y tu cuerpo me va seduciendo.
Well, what a great event. Those marketing students sure are sharp. You know, we learned that sales increased by a few $1,000s that weekend for the restaurant.
That's right, Kurt, and that trend actually continued into the following weekend, where sales almost doubled for the business. It really just brings a smile to your face.
Yeah, that's a lot of chicken.
Perfect. Well, that's it for today. Thank you for tuning in on Channel 4 News. Tomorrow, we'll be discussing how Santa's reindeer have actually caught COVID, and he will be using llamas to pull his sleigh. That's it.
Have a good night, everyone.
Have a good night.